Bioversity International and the International Support Group work together to build professional capacity in participatory research. Four researchers from Burkina Faso, Cameroon, India and Malaysia participated in a two-year on-the-job training program on participatory and gender-responsive research. It provided the participants with an approach, a methodology and the instruments necessary to improve the effectiveness of their research within ongoing programs. Toward the end of the program, they were invited to present their findings at the International Conference of Agricultural Extension and Education in the Netherlands in April 2015. We took the opportunity to inquire into their experience and to highlight some of the lessons they learned.
You did something with participatory research, you did something with gender, and there must have been a particular moment when you say, hey, this is exciting, this is nice. Give us an example like that.
Some people who were used to talking in the crowd could also express themselves, and it made them to brainstorm amongst themselves and share knowledge. Some people didn't know about certain varieties of some forest foods, but after that, with the knowledge shared amongst themselves, they had an idea.
It brought a kind of unity among villagers, and it is for the first time the people, especially the women of indigenous community and other group, they are coming together for the first time in the history of village. And they discuss a lot of things like conservation, ecological status of few species and varieties, and they discuss the possibility of improving the livelihood through value addition marketing. I think that intended outcome, it made me some interesting and surprising. Mm-hmm. Some illiterate women, when we started, they said, no, we never used a pen in our life, and we if you ask us to make a draw of village resource mapping, and you will run away. But when the after 3-4 sessions, and they were very happy to involve. In my opinion, it's not only the conservation issue, management aspect, livelihood, the confidence of the participants, especially indigenous, the women belong to indigenous group. I think that is also important. It's very difficult to reach them. Mm-hmm. If they come to the meeting, they will lose their half day or one day wage. So bringing them to this research process was challenging.
I hear with all of you that something happened. They talked about things they before didn't talk about.
Yeah.
And especially they didn't talk about together.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Different groups.
Yeah.
So that makes a real difference.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
In your case, you really opened their minds up to the fact that there was a market at all.
Yes, yes. When we first started the research project, I was asking these ladies who were involved in this bigger project how much the production was. And I said, that's very little. And they said, we don't have that many mangoes to process. And then when we did our first round of value chain mapping, and we suddenly realized when we heard the men talking, they've been marketing mangoes, a lot of mangoes.
Mm.
So we thought that the men were not telling the women. Actually, the men didn't know that the women needed these mangoes. So it was through our research project that they know each other's problems.
Yeah.
So in the end, what's good is that the men made the mangoes available for the women to do their project.
But that's interesting. You were talking about Burkina.
Yes.
Exactly the same thing. The men and women, of course, they were normally talking to each other, but not about this.
Yes.
And they were not providing this type of information.
Yes.
And in your case, I think where they come together and they actually speak to people and respect and understand the knowledge of people they normally don't draw upon, they start having a different idea of what working together is, isn't it?
Yes.
that seems to come back. People know a lot of things, but they don't think or talk about it, and they don't share that.
They take it for granted sometimes.
You are a technical scientist, right?
Yeah.
I heard.
It was a bit challenging in the beginning because I'm having all this qualitative data. How do I put it into numbers? From some of the trainings we had and the literature I was reading, I realized that it doesn't necessarily have to, I do not necessarily have to quantify it for it to have value. So I could always have the qualitative data and analyze it from that perspective.
Mm. Is it less challenging for a social scientist?
Men always, in all the group discussions, mention that they prefer the ethnovarieties which is more suitable for eating, which is completely different from what women have said in those groups. But within my matrix, it was hard to show it with the numbers.
Is there a way to quantify these things more? Is there a way to say, okay, well, at the end of the day, we will make a nice descriptive statistic of, you know, what we have found and give them some figures?
I think so. In my case, for the access and control matrix, we scored the... We did a scoring of the responses. Like, we used a scoring of 1 to 3. One indicating that probably women had more access, for example, they had more access to land, then 3 in that, no, 1 that they had no access, little or no access, 3 that they had more access, and 2 was like in the middle. So with this scoring, it was much more able to come up with graphs.
Okay.
When I put it into Excel.
And your boss loved that, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yes. I would have loved it. What we are all working on is gender equality, and you have all given examples. What does it actually contribute to the gender equality? How does that work? You know, you have had these conversations, people have been surprised by others, like... You know, people have learned from each other, they have shared knowledge, etc. What were the contributions to gender equality that will stay afterwards? What was it?
I believe that when the women who before did not have confidence in themselves and also did not thought that their knowledge wasn't taken into consideration, if now they feel that what they say is being taken into consideration, and that their knowledge also has value, it will help them to continue in these practices. And because also they do not concentrate just on the economic aspect of it, they look into the food value, the medicinal value, and it's more like they are the custodians of the home, the taker of the home. So if their knowledge is being taken into consideration, it can move the home forward.
This has been a very inspiring conversation. Thank you very much for sharing these concrete experiences from so many different contexts. They show how research can be enriched using participatory and gender-responsive methods and instruments. What I hear clearly is that participatory research is exciting, that participants and researchers gain access to knowledge they never dreamed existed, that it contributes directly to gender equality and the resilience of local communities, and that the rigorous use of instruments can produce robust data to support policy and practice. But you do need to know what you're doing, choose the right instruments, and know how to use them.